Corals have been likened to the Amazon rainforest for two very good reasons. One, we got a high amount of species diversity. Two, we've got potent medicine.
I think coral is alive, and I have no idea what it is.
I think coral is not only a plant, but an animal.
Coral. A color, a life, an ecosystem.
Up until a few years ago, it was jewelry. To me, it was jewelry, but I really enjoyed wearing.
It is a living organism, is what it is.
Well, I think coral are these little tiny animals that live in the ocean. They live in those really pretty colored rock things.
Coral, as far as I know, is a living organism that grows in the reefs or under the waters of tropical ocean.
It's in the ocean.
So what is coral? Do you guys know what coral is?
Coral is a living rock.
Well, coral is actually a colonial organism made of lots of different animals. So here we have a calcium carbonate shell. Actually, inside all these would be one animal. One little polyp.
Even though it's an animal, it's actually a colony of many animals. And there's several different species of coral. When they make up a coral reef, they provide an entire, I guess you can call it kind of like a community, a home for a lot of other fishes and animals.
I don't see the connection.
No connection whatsoever.
I don't have a connection to the reef because I've never really seen it, but it's okay if I do have a little connection because of my good feelings about the nation of Australia.
As far as me being connected to it, I don't know, I mean, how exactly I'm affected.
In a remote way, we're all connected to the ocean, in one way or another.
All living things, aside from that, especially connected to coral as opposed to any other living thing, I'm not quite sure.
Coral reefs are really important for me because of their biological diversity, and I find them fascinating, never-endingly fascinating to look at all the different life forms. In fact, it's my favorite thing to do is to go snorkeling in coral reefs.
Yes, you do.
I do know some people who suffer from cancer.
Oh, yes.
Unfortunately, yes.
Yes.
Yes, my grandfather.
My parents suffered from cancer.
Did I not know that?
I did not know that.
I had no idea. That's shocking.
Me? Neither!
No. That's pretty incredible. I guess we better keep it alive. That's amazing.
It's pretty crazy.
I did not know that at all. That's interesting. I'd like to know more about it. And that's terrific.
It's amazing.
That's pretty cool.
I'm not surprised. I think we're always being surprised by these ecosystems in terms of what they have to offer us that we've for decades or centuries or millennia just overlooked, things we just don't know. And I think it's just one more example of why we should protect all of our ecosystems, is because, you know, they fundamentally, if you want it to be about us, they have something to offer us. And we don't always know what it is. Valuable.
It's one of the most diverse ecosystems on the planet. You can kind of relate it to a rainforest on land, but there's so much life and so many differences that make up a coral reef. Finding all sorts of new things about coral reefs, everything from helping with medicine, and so many things that we still don't know about. So that's something that we need to work on. We have to save an ecosystem like this because we still don't know what's out there.
There are a tremendous amount of discoveries that have been made and are yet to be made. The coral reef is pretty much the equivalent of the rainforest, for example. Just as you would find in a rainforest, you don't have a tremendous amount of biomass, but you do have different types of organisms. Because these organisms are constantly competing for either space or food or any other resource in the environment, they develop weapons and anti-weapons against each other. This seems to and tends to accelerate the development of defenses against invasion by bacteria or viral organisms as well. And so you find antibacterial, antiviral mechanisms that sometimes can be used by us. The preservation is invaluable. It probably won't have a lot of impact on my generation and perhaps even the next generation, although 20 years ago I was studying sponge and had no idea it would have anything to do with HIV and AIDS, and so 20 years from now I'm sure there's something that someone has discovered. To waste any resource can have catastrophic and sadly unpredictable events.
Go!
Go Coral!
I can't believe that.
Really?
I can't. You gotta turn it up.
Ring, 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 ring. Banana phone.
I've got this. Not coral!
Coral.
An abundance of coral and other natural wildlife found underwater coexist in harmony with fishes.
And I've watched SpongeBob SquarePants, much against my will. I've watched this underwater life with Crab the Crab Shack. That's all, folks!
live in colonies of very different forms and sizes. Their annual growth varies from just a few millimeters in certain species to 10 centimeters in others. The reefs are among the most complex living colonies of very different forms and sizes. Their annual growth varies from just a few millimeters in certain species to 10 centimeters in others. The reefs are among the most complex